Hi friends, this is Bogey Naidu. Today, this is the first video on history of photogrammetry. Definition of photogrammetry, brief history of photogrammetry. What is the definition of photogrammetry? Photogrammetry may be defined as the art, science, and technology of obtaining reliable information about physical objects and the environment. This is done through a process of recording, measuring, and interpreting aerial images and patterns of recorded electronic radiation through a device. Here, device is a camera. It is an art and science. It is technology, totally technology and science. Using of we are using science, totally science technology of obtaining reliable information. We are getting the information about the ground features, geospatial features, about physical objects like buildings, road network, water bodies, vegetation, and utility features. All the features on the earth. And in the environment. This is done through a process of recording. To record this data by images and measuring the physical objects dimension, for example, building. To measure the building dimensions, width and length and height also. For example, road, length of the road and width of the road, we find the area of the road. For example, to find any land, to measure the land areas, length and width, it will give the areas. Sometimes we are using quantities of earthwork, quantities of any items. And interpreting of aerial, what is interpretation? Interpretation is to find the unknown values by using of known values is called interpretation of aerial images. Here we are using aerial images to interpret the features and patterns of recorded electronic radiation, EMR spectrum, electromagnetic radiation. By using of this electronic radiation, we record the data, collect the data in the form of images through a device. Here, device is a camera. Any image capturing, basic requirement is camera and light. Here, light is sun and camera, we are captured by using of this camera, we are capturing the data. Photogrammetry is the technique of measuring objects 2D and 3D from photographs. From the photographs, for example, 2D, to find any point of coordinates, 2D means X and Y, and 3D means X, Y, and Z. To find any point on the image, it is 2D image or 3D in stereo. You measure the 3D in stereo images. To measure the any point on the ground by using of aerial images, 2D, find the XY. Main point, it is most important feature is the measuring of the objects without having physical contacts. So measuring of the object without any physical contact. Main difference between the surveying and photograph. Surveying means we go to the field, collect the data, come to the office and calculate the areas and volumes. After finding of areas and volumes, you prepare the maps. After preparation of these maps and set out, as this drawing is setting, marking on the ground. This is the process of surveying. Now here, without touching the physical objects, we capture the data and prepare the maps. This is the input for GIS. This is a photogrammetric surveying. Photogrammetric surveying means surveying done by using a photographic, aerial photographs is called photographic surveying. By camera is fixing bottom of the flight. Flight is going constant speed and capture the images with the constant with the overlap. And to capture any images from this image, to separate the data in layer wise is called layering. For example, in our college having different of ground features, boundary wall, playgrounds, road network, water bodies, building network, vegetation, wasteland, and granary, all these data and electrical poles, electrical lines, all these data separately captured in separate layers is called layering. As per our client requirement or project requirement, you capture this data and use it, or and we are getting the high accuracy result. Main history of the main object of this video is history of photogrammetry. As early as 350 BC, Aristotle has referred to the process of presenting images optically. In the early 18th century, Dr. Brooke Taylor published his treatise on linear perspectives. Views, perspective means views. Leonardo da Vinci, in 1480, when Leonardo da Vinci developed the concept of perspective and projective geometry. What is perspective? Perspective is nothing else than the seeing an object behind a sheet of glass. He is doing some, he is observing the objects by through the glass. By observing this, by observing his eyes to the objects, automatically the things transmitted their images to the eye by pyramidal lines, and these lines, pyramidals, are cut by the said glasses. He has done some experimental by using of glass and observing through the glass, he is observing objects. Next one, Lambert. 1759, Johann Heinrich Lambert, in a treatise Perspective Labor, Free Center for Photogrammetry Training, History of Photogrammetry, he developed the mathematical principles of a perspective image. Has developed one mathematical relation, principles of perspective images, using space resection to find a point in a space from which a picture is made. The relationship between the projective geometry and photogrammetry was first developed by R. Storms and Guido Hawk in Germany in 1883. Next one, Albert Durer. Many of the Da Vinci artistic contemporaries contributed, the other scientists continued this work on projective geometry mathematically. But Albert Durer in 1525, using the laws of perspectives, created an instrument that could be used to create a true perspective drawings. He has invented one instrument. Create perspective drawings. It is very useful for creating drawings. Next one, Nipsey. The first photograph was developed by Joseph Nipsey. The positive image Nipsey required, he has created one image, but taken time of 8 hours for capturing of one image data. He is required 8 hours of exposure. 1827, he used a primitive camera to produce the oldest surviving photographs of a real world scene. Among Nipsey's other inventions was the pyrolophone, the world first internal combustion engine, which he conceived, created, and developed with his older brother. His name also Nipsey. Next one, Jacques Daguerre. He obtained the first practical photograph using a process called the Daguerre type. The Daguerre has been searching since the mid 1920s for a means of capturing the fleeting images. He saw in his camera obscura a draftsman and consisting of a wood box. He has prepared one wood box, and by using of this glass, he observed the objects with a lens at one end and throw an image onto a frosted sheet of glass at the other end. He has done one practical. In 1829, he had formed a partnership with Niphron Nipsey, who had been working on the same problem, how to make a permanent image using light and chemistry. Light and chemistry. Next one, Domenico Francois Jean Arago, 1840, the French jurist Dominique Francois Jean Arago began to advocate the use of photogrammetry. He has begun the use of photogrammetry using the daguerreotype in front of the French Arts and Science Academy. Émile Lacidat, he's a well-known person. In 1849, Émile Lacidat was the first person to use terrestrial photogrammetry. Terrestrial photogrammetry means camera located on the ground, photos captured on the ground. Means it is called terrestrial photographs or topographic maps. What is for topographic? Topographic means natural features and artificial features. Combination of these two features prepare one map is called topographic maps. He is referred to as the father of photogrammetry. Lacidat has father of photogrammetry. The process Lacidat used was called iconometry, meaning to measure the objects in the images. In 1858, he experimented with aerial photography supported by a string of kites, but abandoned it a couple of years later. In 1862, Lacidat use of photography for mapping was officially accepted by the Science Academy in Madrid. He also tried balloons photography and is the first person to have captured an image from balloons. But by using of balloons to capture number of photos per particular point, obtaining sufficient number of photographs to cover all the area from one air station, he is facing some problems. At the Paris Exposition in 1867, Lacidat exhibited the first known theodolite, and his plan to Paris derived from his photographic surveys. These maps were comparable to earlier maps compiled from the conventional field. Conventional field means by using of surveying to capture the data by using of chains, tapes, compasses, and leveling instruments as per the client requirements and the ground surface and the location of the sites, and prepare some maps. He has compared his work to conventional field surveys. Most of the work has matched. Sorry. Next one, Nadir. Nadir used a balloon at 80 meters to obtain the first aerial photograph. In 1859, the Emperor Napoleon ordered Nadir to obtain reconnaissance photography in preparation of the Battle of Solferino, France-Prussian War during the 1870. He has captured number of photos in the war. Most of the photos used, he is captured. Porro Ingaggio Petro was an Italian geodetist and optical engineer. As a geodetist, he invented the first tachometer. In 1847, he was able to improve image quality of lens system all the way to edges by using three systematical lens elements. He improved the quality of the image. Perro developed a panoramic camera in 1858 that was equipped with a sighting telescope, compass, and level. At the same time, three are combined telescope to observe the objects by using a compass to measure the angle measurements, and a leveling by using a leveling instrument to find the levels. The image was recorded on sensitized paper mounted on a cylinder. In 1865, he designed the photogoniometer. This development is significant in photogrammetry because of its application. He removing lens distortion. This concept is called the Perocopy principle. He has invented one more instruments. Next one, Eastman, 1885. George Eastman used nitrocellulose as a film base and later replaced the photographic dry plate for roll film. This is one of the change. This Eastman, in the US, James Fairman was issued a patent for an apparatus for aerial photography on August 2, 1987. This device used a camera supported by either a balloon or a kite with the shutter being operated with a clock mechanism. This was the first aerial photography captured from a balloon in the US. On December 12, 1893, Cornelie B. Adams was given a patent for his method of photogrammetry. His approach was to obtain two aerial photos of the same area with the camera from two positions of a captured balloon. To same area to observe two positions. This will give the 3D. Meidenbauer, in 1893, he was the first person to use the term photogrammetry. He founded the Royal Prussian Photogrammetric Institute. He has served as its director until 1909. He designed his first camera in 1867. This was the first wide-angle lens used for mapping. He has invented one camera. Wide angle means this is a covering area. A covering area in between the two lines, the angle is 105. Pantoshop lens. It was used for the topographic maps of Freiburg, Germany, and the structural drawing of St. Mary's Church. According to Mayer, a good draftsperson could obtain the photographic coordinates using devices to an accuracy of about 0.1 mm. He observed and explained. Good draftsman, precision is high accuracy up to 0.1 mm. As for the resulting map would have an accuracy of about 0.2 mm. High accuracy was achieved in Meidenberg's method because he used a large format size 40 by 40 centimeters. Next one, Edouard Develi in Canada, the Surveyor General of the Dominion, invented the first stereoscopic plotting instrument called the planigraph in 1896. This was the first attempt to use stereo overlapping photos. The complexity of the instrument resulted in little use, but this is a very updation. Overlapping of two images, we are getting the 3D. He was very successful in the mapping of the Canadian Rocky Mountains and is referred to as Canada's father of photogrammetry. The US Geological Survey began to use photogrammetry for topographic mapping in 1904. C.W. Wright and F.E. Wright took photos from the ground using a panoramic camera in their survey in Alaska. They used a commercial camera modified by adding level bubbles and internal scales within the camera. He changed his scales also. Next, the development in photogrammetry from around 1850 have followed four development cycles. Each of these periods extended about 50 years. These cycles include plane table photogrammetry, start 1850 to 1900, analog photogrammetry, 1900 to 1960, analytical photogrammetry, 1960 to 1990, last generation digital photogrammetry without image from 1990. These are the four generation development cycles. First one, plane table photogrammetry. the plane table photogrammetry. In this plane table, we are using simple one plane table. The plane table having three legs. On the plane table, you fix that drawing sheet with clips. To put one telescope on the table, observe the objects, and capture the all the surrounding features on the drawing sheet. This is the first generation photogrammetry. The second one, this plane table photogrammetry is an extension of the conventional plane table surveying. As well as plane table surveying is used in surveying, but plane table photogrammetry, this is the extension. Each exposure station was determined by resection. Resection means to fix the third point by using of two known points. Means to find the unknown point by using of known points is called resection. And plotting on this plane table, the exposed photos were obtained on the plane table and the directions to the different objects were transferred onto the map sheet. Analog photogrammetry, these are the analog photogrammetry, totally mechanical. By using a mechanical device to capture the, to prepare the maps. After capturing of images, by using of these images to prepare the maps by as per our client requirement and suitable skills. This analog photogrammetry start 1900 to 1960, but totally mechanical. When are the computers invented, third generation is analytical photogrammetry off of the mechanical knowledge, and we are here using off of the computer knowledge and prepare by using of this knowledge, mechanical and computers, to prepare the maps is called analytical photogrammetry. Here you see the one hand, by using of one hand he is moving X direction, other hand Y direction. Previously analog photogrammetry, here by using of one hand rotating on a circle, this is used for moving of X direction, one circle is Y direction, and by using his legs moving of Z. By moving of X, Y, Z, he is used three, right hand, left hand, and his leg also. Last generation digital photogrammetry. Digital photogrammetry is totally images, without any images. By using of this digital photogrammetry, having number of rows and number of columns, by using of this digital photogrammetry, directly used as a input for GIS. The advantages of using digital photogrammetry, appropriate way of displaying and measurement, stability, applying image enhancement. Enhancement means to increase the quality of the image, automatic can be applied. Real-time photogrammetry is not out of access. These are the applications of digital photogrammetry. What are the purpose of maps? The purpose of for this maps are required in the administration of the country, especially in undeveloped countries such as Africa, are many are varied. Maps are necessary to define the exact limits of the national territory boundaries, to show the areas and villages under the rule of native chiefs. They are essential for the land registrations and settlements, for the allotment of mining and forest concessions, and for the organization of internal communications. By this map, to observe all the ground features, and by this maps, we are identifying the selection of these sites and estimate the forest area and the agriculture area and settlements and the development of these cities. These are all our points are observed by using of these maps. History of photogrammetry again. Aerial photography was used extensively during World War I and II also used. These are the points covered in our PPT. Thank you very much. We'll meet and again in a second part. Sir,